Yo, yo, what's poppin', y'all? ItsJSansi back in this thing. Today, I'm coming at you guys with another Splitgate video. Got some big news. Your boy hit top 50 in the world. I'm still grinding. I really want to get top 10, but for the moment, I'm not going to be greedy. I'm happy with where I'm at, so go check out the leaderboards. You will see me on there, and hopefully I keep going up, man. Now, I'm going to take a second to show you guys my stats. Nothing crazy, nothing too impressive, but I am proud of them. The KD could be better. However, this is really a grind. I solo queue a lot, so, you know, I got to play the objective, and I'm just trying to win at the end of the day. So now, let's get straight into some good gameplay for you guys. This is some Master Lobby gameplay from the new Season 0. I really have been grinding this ever since it dropped. These lobbies are really difficult. A lot of these players are super good. I'm playing the top 25 players in the world most of the time because they're usually always on. So these players are really good. It's really difficult and it's just a grind. I've learned a lot of things throughout playing this game for a short amount of time. Like when I first started, portaling just seemed kind of impossible for me, and I would see guys flying around the map and just never think that I would get to that level. However, with the certain amount of hours practice, you definitely do get to that level. It takes some time and it's not easy, and you can always get better. Movement in this game is something that I feel like it's almost never going to be peaked or maxed out. You're always going to be able to get better and improve it. So just keep working on it, learn different spots on the map, learn different routes, and that's really, really important. Another thing I want to say to people is make sure you play the objective. If you're truly trying to rank up in this game, don't play for KD, don't just play for kills. Honestly, what you should focus on is damage and score. Just focus on playing the objectives, helping your team out, and King of the Hill, make sure you are on the hill, be in the circle. And if you have two teammates in the circle, either be on it with them or be right outside of the hill protecting them. In domination, make sure you are getting flags, and you don't always have to be running around the map getting flags. If you have two flags captured, be sure to sit on one, camp a flag, help your team out. If you have more flags than them, you're constantly gaining score. Just hold those positions. Another really important tip: in team deathmatch, it doesn't matter if you win 1-0 or 50-0, you just need to go positive. People get too wrapped up in the kills, and don't get confused. Kills is your assist and your kills. In TDM, it's really your score to your deaths. If you have 8 kills and 5 assists, it'll show 13 kills. However, you truly only have 8 and your score could be 8 deaths, so you might only really be even. So in TDM, be sure to focus on having more score than deaths. Focus on going positive because that's all you need to do to win. But remember, this is not a kill death game. No one truly cares what your KD ratio is. They just want to know what your rank is and how good you are and how often you win. That's all that matters. Win, win, win. Another really important tip to help you guys win some more matches is focus on power weapons. You got to learn the spawns of these weapons, learn routes to get there first as soon as the map starts. Also learn the respawn times for these weapons, and keep in mind during the game that this weapon is going to spawn in 30 seconds, 1 minute, and play for that. There's really different tiers of power weapons. Things like the shotgun and the rocket launcher are the best weapons in the game. Obviously, the railgun is also up there as well. So if you can get these weapons in something like King of the Hill, it's so easy to just turn a corner with rockets and completely wipe a team and get an easy clean break on a hill because you have rockets, or you can railgun a couple people, shotgun a couple people. These weapons can be the difference of winning and losing a map. Obviously, no game is ever easy, and this one definitely is not. The skill gap in this game is very big, and it's hard to find your way through the ranks and get better at this game. However, if you put the time in, you focus on what you're doing each map and each life, each scenario, really focus on what you're doing. Focus on the routes you're taking. Focus on if your team has the lead or if you have the hill or if you need to go cap a flag. Really focus on the score. You need to be attentive. Make sure you're always paying attention to the game. Make sure you know what your team needs you to do. Roles in this game are tricky. Yes, there is sometimes is a Slayer role. There sometimes is an OBJ role. There sometimes is all that. However, I just feel like it works best if everybody on the team plays the objective. Everybody on the team caps flags. Everybody on the team has their feet in the hill. It will work better. You will win more games, and it really is going to help your chemistry out with your teammates. So as always, guys, that's going to be it for today. Thank you guys for watching. I'm going to have a ton of Splitgate videos coming out, so please be sure to check up on those and subscribe, like this video, comment with any questions. If you want to play together, I'm always down to play with people. I'm usually solo queuing, like I said, but that's it for today, y'all. Until next time, peace out.